Deep down joy that the world didn't give to me. And I need to stop letting the world steal my joy. Amen, somebody. Weeping, someone said this morning, weeping on Thursday night, weeping may endure till the night, but joy coming in the morning. Amen, somebody. What God has given you, don't let the world steal it from you. Paul was talking about joy, but he was serious about joy. We said it before in Philippians 1, he says, he makes it clear that the reason why he is willing to give up everything for his greatest desire of his heart. And the greatest desire of his heart is to commune with Jesus Christ face to face. Yes. Paul made it clear that I want to be with Jesus.
Yes, yes.
And anything I can do, I want to be with Jesus.
Yes.
He was serious about obtaining that joy. He was serious enough that he was willing to give up for a time the immediately enjoyment of being with Jesus Christ in heaven. He told the Philippians, I can go right now. But rather, I'm going to stay for your own good. I'm going to stay for a little while. What kind of person would trade heaven for a little while in order to stay with God's people? He said, I'm going to give up my greatest desire. I want to be with Jesus. All of us ought to want to be with him.
Yeah.
Your greatest desire ought to be that I want to be in heaven.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
Stop seeking the joy of the world, the good feelings of the world, the material stuff of the world.
Yeah.
But our destination is to be with Christ.
Yeah.
Amen, y'all.
Yeah.
Your destination right now is not to get to your house.
Oh.
Amen. Because if the Lord stopped you right then and there and take you out of this world, you ought to be prepared to go and be with him.
Amen?
Amen. His joy, his joy. Paul attacked a false teaching which kills people's joy. That false teaching was putting confidence in the flesh. To trust in our own selves. To trust in our own goodness. Rather than trusting in Jesus Christ. As he offered the gospel to the people, he was telling them, stop falling for that false stuff. Stop falling for that false stuff that we deserve to have certain things on our own. You can't get it by yourself. You got to depend on the Lord. Paul was saying, stop falling for it and have no confidence in the flesh. Amen? The flesh is limited. Paul warns us that the flesh is evil. There is a difference between the flesh and the spirit. Amen? The flesh goes after bad stuff. Evil stuff. But the spirit looks to the good things of the Lord. Amen? I know we in the flesh, but we should not be of the flesh. We ought to be of the spirit. Paul said, if anybody could brag about what I've done in the flesh, Paul said, I could. He said, because I have accomplished a lot. But he tells us that he counted all that fleshly confidence as rubbish, as loss, as nothing in comparison in knowing Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Paul makes it clear, if we are going to enjoy and express real joy, we're going to have to put our confidence in Jesus and not in flesh. We got to trust Jesus and not ourselves. We got to trust Jesus and not the weatherman or the weatherwoman. We got to trust Jesus and not the government. We got to trust God and not our friends. Amen? We went to our grandparents' day and went early in the morning and we was passing down and the minister said, honey, look, the palm reader. Now this is 8:30 in the morning. The parking lot was full. Y'all didn't catch that? Y'all must go to the palm readers. Huh? Hmm? The parking lot was full. There was one Friday, because we went there with Jada, and then the next Friday we go there with Jada, and the parking lot still full. In the morning. Somebody can help me up in here? No matter what tomorrow brings, all I know is the Lord will make a way. Somebody can help me up in this place.
Amen?
Can I tell you what it's going to be like? Hallelujah. for a judgment seat that's higher than this pulpit. Amen? Why do you think the pulpit is higher than the benches, than the pews? It's giving you an example of where God was saying, I ain't God. I just speak for him. Hallelujah. They tell me that there is a book that's going to be read before everybody. Did y'all catch the point? It's going to be read before everybody. Did you really catch the point? A book going to be read where everybody going to hear that book. Everything you did in life will be read to everybody else. Now you tell me you don't have enough time. Amen. Yeah.
And put that sheep in
The other sheep stay laying down. Now that's amazing, y'all. Hallelujah, somebody. There are hundreds of sheep, and he only got 15 sheep. And when he comes, they hear his voice. Because they know his voice. Do you know the voice of Jesus? Jesus was born again because there were other shepherds who wished to steal somebody else's sheep. Helping somebody. So they would come in and call the sheep. And if the sheep followed that shepherd, that's the wrong shepherd. I saw God tell us some of us been following the wrong shepherd. Because we hear the wrong voice. Somebody go help me up in here. Instead of hearing the voice of Jesus, we hear the voice of selfishness. Hallelujah, y'all. Me, myself, and I. It's all about me.